In this illustration, we'll be calculating the power developed by friction on a body. Here, a body of mass m is projected on a rough horizontal surface with velocity v naught at x equals to 0. The friction coefficient on surface is varying with distance as mu is equals to bx. We are required to find the maximum instantaneous power of friction force during motion of body and instantaneous power for friction force as a function of distance traveled x. So here in this situation we can see, if this is a body which is projected from x equals to 0 and right now it is located at x, the friction acting on it will be mu mg and mu can be written as bx. So we can write at position x, acceleration of body is, body acceleration can be written as minus of f by m, this is minus mu g, which can be written as minus bgx. If the body is moving with a speed v, we can write a as v dv by dx, and further we can write v dv is equals to minus bgx dx. And if we integrate this with limits at x equals to 0, the speed was v naught, and at a position x, the speed changes to v. Then on integrating, this will give us v square by 2, and here it is x square by 2. 2 gets cancelled out, and we can further write v square minus v naught square is equals to minus bgx square, which will give us the instantaneous speed of particle as a function of position, which is root of v naught square minus bgx square. So we can write instantaneous power of friction force at position x is, this power we can write as friction is opposite to velocity, it will be negative as we take power as f dot v. So this is minus of friction multiplied by speed. So this will be minus the value of friction acting here is mu mg. So this will be bx mg multiplied by root of v naught square minus bgx square. This is one answer for the instantaneous power of friction as a function of x. And further we can calculate here p is maximum when dp by dx is equals to 0. So here we can differentiate this function by product rule as this is equals to here bmg is a constant, and if we keep this root of v naught square minus bgx square as it is, so this will be root of v naught square minus bgx square multiplied by derivative of x is 1, and then further we can keep this x as it is in this situation. So here this will be plus x multiplied by derivative root of v naught square minus bgx square is 1 by 2 root of v naught square minus bgx square multiplied by minus 2bgx. And if you equate it to 0, further simplifying we can cross multiply here, 2 gets cancelled out, and this will give us v naught square minus bgx square minus bgx square is equals to 0, and further on simplifying we are getting the value of x is equals to v naught divided by root of 2bg. So this is the value of x at which we can see the power will be maximum. Here it could be maximum or minimum, but I'm leaving it as an exercise for you to find the second derivative dp by dx, and by substituting x you can verify that at this value of x p will be maximum. And if we substitute it in this function, here we can see the value of maximum power we are getting is in this function, it is minus bmg multiplied by x. We can write as v naught by root 2bg multiplied by root of v naught square minus bg. X square here is v naught square by 2bg. And on simplifying, we are getting the value is half m v naught square root of bg. That will be the final result of this problem.